Hello everyone, this is Trend Trader here. Once again, we meet for another weekly market analysis and market update. So we've got some stocks that we'll be looking for the week of the 21st to the 25th of September 2020. And as usual, we start with our risk disclaimer. Everything that we share on this video is not to be taken as an investment advice. We are just sharing ideas with you. So for this week, we've got a couple of stocks that we are looking to add into our portfolio. We also got some update on some of the trades that we took from the previous weeks and what's on our watch list. So the first stock that we are looking at is AdTech. We're looking to buy this company. So we've been monitoring it. As you can see now, it just broke above the 200-day moving average. So now that is our buy signal. We are looking to buy at this level with a close 1.58 are below 935. Or whatever price that we'll get from the market. So that's the first stock that we want to add. The second one that we'll be adding is Afrimat. As you can see, Afrimat is at its all-time high. It broke above this level. So yeah, it's a bit stretched away from the 20-day moving exponential average. The best price to enter was around 38 rand, but we missed that move. But we are going to buy this because we also buy all-time highs as they happen. So yeah, we're also looking to add Afrimat. That's another stock. And the third stock that we're looking at is Omnia. As you can see, Omnia has been trending lower for a long time and then started to consolidate on the side from the middle of 2019 up until now. We tried to buy Omnia at this level, but the trade didn't work out, so we had to exit. So now this is our second attempt, as here it also broke the 200-day moving average and closed above. So we're also looking to buy around this level and also have our stop 1.58R below our entry price. The fourth stock that we're looking at is Peregrine. So yeah, we've neglected this for quite some time. As you can see, the stock is somewhat volatile. The movement, it's a bit erratic, but it's holding the 20-day moving average very well. So we can't help but to follow our strategy. If it's trending high, we buy. No feelings. We don't care what the company does. We just buy what's trending up. We sell what's trending down. So yeah, we're also looking to buy Peregrine. And another one that caught our attention is Supergroup. Same thing. Supergroup closed above the 200-day moving average for quite some time now, and it's holding that level very well. So now it has our attention. As you can see, it broke out of this base here. So it shows to us, it indicates a strength in the upside direction. So we'll be looking to buy a Supergroup as well. Let's see. Then from Supergroup, we have Tiger Brands. Same thing. Close above 200-day moving average. As you can see, there have been multiple attempts to close above 200-day moving average. One, two. Okay, this one didn't close above. A third one, a fourth one, probably fifth, and now it's the sixth time. So we will be buying this as well. We'll be adding this onto our portfolio. And as usual, we have some stocks that we're not really buying, but keep tabs on them. So this week we've got Massmart. So, there have been a lot of talks in various social media, people discussing this stock. Same thing, I think this was an attempt above the 200-day moving average, but it's been trending lower, as you can see, lower highs, sorry, lower lows, lower lows, lower lows, and then it attempted to break out, but it failed, went back again, trended lower, and it attempted to break out again around 30 rands. So yeah, but it closed lower. We are monitoring it as well. As you can see here, it looks like there's a bit of support on the 20-day exponential moving average. So we'll see if it will go back up and close above the 200-day moving average, or it will break lower and probably find support on the 50-day moving average. We will just have to wait and see how does that go. And an update from some of the positions that we had previously. Okay, we're looking at Aspen. We spoke about Aspen, I think, on our very first YouTube video. And we mentioned that we're up by a couple of percentages. We're up a couple of percentages, but it's been consolidating to the side. It broke below this support level. In fact, it started breaking down below the 200-day moving average. That's where we exited our position. But we're also looking to see if it will find support around this level. So far, it broke below this support. So we are no longer in position with Aspen. In fact, by the end of this week, we are holding 50% cash because we had to exit a lot of positions as the market starting to trend lower and lower. And also we had a Coronation Fund. We attempted to buy it when it broke and closed above the 200-day moving average, but it just moved sideways for quite some time until it gave up. So we exited the position yesterday at around 39 rand 50 or so. So we took a loss on that one. And we've been holding this gold debenture ETF. As you can see, we bought it around March. I think that's when we sold most of our stocks due to COVID-19 because some companies started to break lower. So we first moved into cash. We saw that gold was trending higher, so we bought a gold ETF. We've been holding it ever since. And then a few weeks ago, we mentioned that it went up and we're waiting to see if it will find support at the 200 at the 20-day moving average, of which it didn't. And then on Thursday, it broke below 50-day moving average and it closed below it. So for that reason, we decided to liquidate all the position and went back to cash. But we are still monitoring that position because what might happen is that it will go and close below. Let's see. Okay, there is an error. It can go and find support somewhere here, or it can, instead of going down, it can go back up. Whichever way, if it goes down, wait until it comes back to the 200-day moving average. And if it finds support, we will buy. If it doesn't, we still don't have a position. Or if it breaks above the 50-day moving average, we will buy again. But maybe not at this level if it breaks above its all-time high. And then we also had a position with Sibanye that we've been holding. As you can see, we bought Sibanye around April as well. At Sibanye, we up at some point we're up 105%. We held it all the way up. We took our 30% profit or 30% position at 20% profit. And then now we're monitoring this, but as soon as it closed below the 20-day moving average at this level, we sold another 30% to keep most of our profit. So now we're only left with 40% of the position or 40% of the original position. So we are monitoring this stock. We want to see if it will find support here and continue to trend up, or it will break down below a 50-day moving average. If it breaks down, We expect it will continue to trade lower until it finds support on the 200-day moving average. But time will tell. We don't have a crystal ball. We're just monitoring the position. We are also looking at Impala, same thing that we did with Sibanye. We bought it earlier. It was up over 30%. We took some profit at 20% price appreciation. And then as it started to show weakness, breaking below the 20-day exponential moving average, we sold another 30%. So now we are left with 40% of the original position. We are also monitoring the stock. We want to see if it will close below the 50-day moving average or it will find the support and start trending up again. But we also noted that I think yesterday was the last trading day for dividend. So we're not worried about that because we still have 40% of the position remaining on the market. We've kept enough position, so I don't think the dividend will make will give us more money. We've already pocketed enough. So that's it for this week. The stocks that we're looking to buy again is Advtech, Afrimet, Omnia, Peregrini, Supergroup, and Tiger Brand. We have Omnia on our watch list, and we just gave an update on Aspen, Coronation Gold ETF, Sibanye Gold, and Impala Platinum. So yeah, for us, well, we are traders, neither short term or long term. We just buy what's moving up. We sell what goes lower. We don't have a specific time frame. We can sell anything. Like for example, TFG, we bought TFG on Tuesday. On Thursday, we exited the position. I think that was the shortest we've ever held a position because it's been like 3 days and a couple of hours. So for us, we see ourselves as risk managers rather than investors. If the market moves against us, we exit the position. If the market moves in our favor, we follow the trend. We keep or capture as much of the profit as possible. And that's it for this week. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video. If you've got any questions, you can ask on the comment sections. We will attend to each and every comment. Thank you. See you next week.